This is a gaggle of geese. You may wonder why that's so important to mention. But I bet if you watch this video all the way to the end, the reason will be revealed. As odd as this may seem, every goose among these geese has their own story to tell. It's not every day that you see a goose with a limp. I wonder how that came to be. See this group of dancers? It's more than a bunch of individuals. They all know the steps. Like the geese, each dancer has their own story. Sort of like you. But your story is most interesting. No one can tell your story better than you. What we do is project your uniqueness and make it possible for you to stand out from the crowd. First of all, to make people feel at ease, we use funny little catch-all words. Words like things, stuff, widgets, digits, doohickeys, and mess. We use these placeholder words like scientists use placebo. Never mind the fact that these disarming little words are pointless, meaningless, and even nothingness. They make people think we might know what we're talking about in an unsophisticated, folksy kind of way. To grab their attention, we show them unusual places and things they don't see every day. Look at these people who routinely jump off of a moving train. Who was the first or even the second person to try it? This gives a whole new meaning to the concept of a flag stop. We leave indelible impressions with the use of these uncommon images. Then we use everyday images to bridge the gap and reinforce people's pre-existing beliefs. The soda server asks, "How much do you want?" The customer replies, "Just enough, a little bit, or whatever you think." See how these little phrases respond to the question, but in actuality decide nothing at all? People use non-committal word combinations like these to pass the buck and force someone else to make the decision. No one wants to be responsible for it, whatever it is. The server does not want to assume responsibility. The server will start to pour and then turn the table by saying, "Tell me when." I still, for the life of me, can't tell you what a gaggle is. I don't think I like that word, gaggle. I struggle with nondescript words like that. Like most people, I like simple words. Words that make things crystal clear. When something has a name, that name ought to unmistakably indicate what that thing is. Take, for example, the swing. It's called a swing because it swings. It doesn't get any simpler than that. There are other examples, like the insect we call a fly, the machine we call a photocopier, clothespins, paper clips, fans, sparklers, raindrops, or even lightning. You get the picture. Distractions, the things people spend their time thinking about instead of the shortcomings in their own lives. These are the things that anesthetize the pain. The things in real life that are really make-believe, like imaginary friends, the celebration, the fanfare. Those are the rewards for hard work and even harder play. It's important that we make people believe we care about the same things they care about, to convince them that their priorities are our priorities, and that we too want to make the world a better place, not for us, but for them. We want them to feel we are an integral part of their story, but it's all really just sleight of hand. We don't know them from a hill of beans. We program them to think about the things we want them to remember. Long after this video is over, you will be thinking about the phrase, a gaggle of geese. Did you know that a group of geese is only called a gaggle when they are walking around on the ground? When they take flight, they become a team. What's good for the gander is good for the gaggle. What's good for you is good for us. Let's team up so that we can help you separate yourself from the gaggle and become the goose that laid the golden egg.